Hi, mister. I don't have breakfast. Somebody else has it. Yeah. Mister. You showing everybody what you do in lockout? Hi, bud. Hey, good morning, everybody. So it's Brittany and Aries Cougar at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. Yeah. Hurry up with that food cart. I don't think you're gonna eat in that one anyway. Yeah, the door would be down. You'll have to go around. Oh, some water. Well, I see that people are watching, but I'm not seeing any comments. Oh, there we go. Good morning, Jane. Now I'm seeing hearts and likes. Good morning, Anne-Marie. This is Aries Cougar at Big Cat Rescue for those of you just joining. Good morning, Jan in Texas. Thanks for watching. It's Monday morning. Happy March, everybody. Normally today would be a medical Monday, and it is. Dr. Justin's here, but we won't be doing any hospital procedures today. They are just working on vaccines for some of the cats, so I'm gonna be steering clear of a couple areas because I don't want to be a distraction. Yeah. Because they have already done vaccines with Sue and Lakota. We've been trying to catch Levy Bobcat. Yeah, for weeks. And unfortunately, they're gonna have to net her in order to do her vaccines. And Kali Tiger will get vaccines today. Thank you very much for the donation. Aries is showing you his favorite new spot. He's always liked the platforms, but he used to like the other platform on the other end. Yeah, now he seems to like this one. Probably because he gets a better view of the path. He's gonna stay settled up there. I'd like to get a little closer so you can hear his purring. He's actually doing fine. You know, he has lived here for 14 years with two siblings that have recently passed away. Mister! I can hear you purring. Hi, bud. He still very much has a good appetite. He is also taking the kidney supplement that many of our other cats are taking. Seems to enjoy those extra treats. Good morning, Cynthia. Hi, Chris. This is Aries Cougar. Can always tell by that purr. Look at that big old tail. I see you're closed up here so that you have two doors down. Morning, Leah. Morning, Anne and Dawn. We just got started. We've just been here with our beautiful Aries Cougar. He thinks he's gonna eat in this lockout, but if you're familiar with us, you know that we lock our big cats out for breakfast time, which means there's a door between them and us and the food. But because Aries is extra excited about food, no, mister. Because he's extra excited about food, he has to have two doors down. So he's currently just up here in this bubble. And then there's a tunnel over here that has a door down. So that's his two doors. Between him and breakfast, he's most likely eating. He still has access to the entire unit that he used to have, but looks like he's gonna be eating in this middle lockout because that door is down. That's how we do it here. Cougars and larger, no matter who they are, get the lockout doors put down at breakfast time. And then we have a handful of small cats that are very excited for food. Hi, mister. Yeah. Thank you, Miriam, for the donation. Yep, cougars and smaller can still purr. Anything larger makes that more of a sawing. Sounds like a chainsaw or almost like a motorcycle.
Kieran, would you switch over to 3, please?
And then that even bigger goes into the roar. I don't see Frankie. I was going to see if Frankie was out. Frankie's still enjoying Funcation. I think this is his last week, but I haven't heard officially. I see Jinx slinking around over there. You guys want to go see Jinx?
All right. Last drive-by. I know. Last drive-by. Breakfast will be here in a minute.
So we just got started a few minutes ago. We've just seen Aries Cougar so far. Let's walk down and see Jinx. Jinx is always really fun and playful before breakfast. I like showing you the cats while they're waiting for breakfast because they're a lot more active. This is their most exciting time of the day. Anytime you've got a captive wild cat, they should be able to roam hundreds of square miles a day, but because they were born and raised in captivity by people, they can never go free, sadly. So we spend a lot of time making sure they have a lot of toys and enrichment, permanent and just random enrichment throughout the days and weeks. But breakfast time by far is their most favorite time of day. And once they've had breakfast, they go sleep. And then they're less, you're less likely to really see them and how cool they are. Some fun activity levels. Let's see, where did he go? I saw him from way over there, but I knew as soon as I started coming this way, he went into flat cat mode. Ah, yep.
Right where he was. Did you think I brought the food, mister? I wish I did. I wish I had brought it for you. Hi, my love. Hi, my love. I missed you.
I've been gone since Thursday. Today's my first day back, so like I always do, I've walked around every single cat telling them I loved them and missed them.
Do you have cinnamon on your head?
I think he has cinnamon on his head. All of a sudden, I could smell cinnamon.
Was you playing with... Oh, yeah, look, his bag is over here. Were you playing with your bag? Yes, it's wet. I see it. He has cinnamon on his forehead. I see that it's got fresh bite marks. You playing?
That's very fun. So this is Jinx, our black leopard. He is a goofball.
Look at that bag.
You have so much cinnamon on your forehead, babe.
You gotta brush that off. You gotta use your paw and brush that off.
I knew I smelled cinnamon. At first I thought he just had like a little bit of sunbeam on his forehead.
Nope, it's cinnamon. How funny is that?
On Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays, we do keeper tours. And keeper tours hand out a lot of enrichment, so spice bags like he has there.
You are so silly.
Look at his beautiful spots in the sunshine. But they hand out lots of spice bags and perfume tubes, and a lot of the cats will play with them for days as long as it doesn't rain and they get ruined. But generally they have it for about a day, and then the cleaners will come around after feeding the next day and pull all that kind of stuff out.
You gotta roll around and rub your head on the ground to get that off. Yeah. Where are you going? You gonna play with your log?
Yeah, you could rub it on the log. There we go. That'll work.
You could rub it on the log. Just don't get it in your eyeball.
That is the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, it does look like Rafiki got him. Are you the new Lion King?
Oh my goodness.
Oh, if you want to see their reaction to catnip, there's like 100 different videos on our YouTube channel. We hand out a lot of catnip here. You can literally just Google if big cats like catnip, and our video on our YouTube channel will probably come up first. That's bigcattv.com. If you've never seen our YouTube channel, make sure you go subscribe there. That's all of our produced and edited videos. And if you want to rewatch lives and walkabouts and Q&As, and we actually have a presentation tonight for the interns and volunteers. And I think that, I don't know if they're going to do that live or if they're just recording it or both, but things like that, go over to dailybigcat.com.
Are you stalking again?
And that's where you'll find all these types of videos. Just hours and hours of fun.
That's so funny, sir.
So funny.
He's very smart. He knows who's going to feed him.
See his beautiful spots.
What you doing?
He does look like he's thinking.
You thinking about something?
Oh, hilarious.
All right, get into position. I hear the cart. I hear the cart coming. I hear that cart coming. There we go, back into position.
I can't blow his cover, so we're gonna head out. Bethany and Sky will be over here in a minute to give him breakfast. Okay. Manny is in. Lockout eating, or about to eat. Well, no, if he's in lockout, he's already eating. Let's see. Let's see where Armani maybe is. There's Alethea, who's about to get breakfast. So today is ivermectin. The first Monday of every month is ivermectin, and so that is very important that they get that. So they put a little bit in just a piece of their food. That's the first piece that we have to give them. And once we know that they have taken the medicine, then they get the whole rest of the diet. That's why any of you that watch the rehab camera probably saw me go out this morning and give Romeo one chick, and that's because that has the ivermectin in it. And we need him to take that, and then he'll get the rest of his breakfast.
Good morning, Candy.
Yeah.
Oh, there's Miss Armani. Ow. Did you take all your food? Ow. Yep, your meds. Good girl. Ow. Wow. Hi, beautiful. Wow.
This is Armani, a female leopard. So just like Jinx, only a golden leopard, not a black leopard. Same kind of spot pattern. Yeah, but Jinx has a trait called melanism, which creates the black coat.
Wow, where'd she go? Did she take all the rest of the food? I think you ate all your food.
Wow.
Baby girl.
So So again, it's Medical Monday, but we're not doing anything in the hospital. They're out right now handing out vaccines to cats that need it, plus the ivermectin for today. So that's why I'm doing a normal walkabout today. Normally, I would just wait until we're in the hospital because it usually takes several hours. Here's Miss Natalia on her morning walk. Hi, lady. Spot to see her. Natalia came to us from a zoo, and she has this habit of after breakfast time.
Hi.
She spends a lot of time walking in a big circle, and then eventually she'll go lay down and groom for a long time. So she has to get her steps in. Nope, that noise that Armani makes is very original to Armani. And with Natalia, you get the hissing.
Hiss. Hi.
And so you'll see Natalia's also a leopard, but she's an Amur leopard, and she's a lot fluffier.
She's a much fluffier tail. Much fluffier tail.
She does this every morning after breakfast, and then she does it again in the late afternoon. As I mentioned earlier, these cats should be able to roam hundreds of square miles in a day and eat at their leisure, but since they're trapped in captivity and can never be set free, she's been institutionalized, so she does this walking in a circle. Yep, she has a circle in every bubble, actually. So it's not even necessarily a certain area. She does it. She has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She has 5 bubbles that are all connected by tunnels and doors. And each one of them has a walking circle. And when she goes on Funcation, which is 22,000 square feet, she does this in the back bubble circle. So
she's just a fitness guru, aren't you, lady?
I wish that's what it was. It does make me very sad to see the type of behaviors the captive cats have. When you go to zoos and backyard menageries and roadside zoos and things like that, you tend to see a lot of behavioral issues with cats where they over-groom themselves or they're pacing to pure exhaustion. All that kind of stuff is caused from these cats being trapped in cages. You can help us put a stop to that by making the Call of the Wild, helping us pass the Big Cat Public Safety Act. That's Armani. So that's the sawing noise. These cats don't purr, but they make that roaring, sawing noise. Was Armani Leopard. So she makes that croaking noise, but she also makes that sawing noise.
Baby, what are you talking about? That, yeah. Wow. That was a lot to say.
Wow.
Nope, it doesn't dispense treats yet. Sorry.
Here's Manny.
Full belly Manny. Hey, Mr. Man. Hey, mister.
So Manny's a jaguar. You guys have seen 3 leopards and now a jaguar. You can definitely tell the difference between their head shape, their spot patterns, the length of their fur. He's stalking the feeders across the street. goes Beth Ann. And there goes Manny. He's gonna go stalk Jinx getting breakfast. That's his new favorite hobby. So he'll walk all the way down there. And he'll lay in the lockout across from Jinx's lockout and just watch him eat. So goofy.
Alright, lady. Last drive by. Did you just get some water? Wow. Good job. Wow. Hi. You gonna keep sawing?
She tends to do that sawing noise a lot after breakfast.
I know. Are you trying to be sneaky? I'm trying to be extra sneaky.
All right, guys. Well, we have seen Aries Cougar. We saw Jinx the Black Leopard. We saw Armani and Natalia Leopards. Manny Jaguar. Let's go see if Kimba Tiger is out. Just walking around. I have to walk all the way around Armani's enclosure to get to a gate. Probably in the next half hour, Natalia will be up on top of that platform. That's where she spends almost every day. But not till she gets her steps in. All right. So we'll walk around the corner here, see if Kimba's out, and then we'll try to maybe see a couple of the small cats, and then we'll call this a day. Again, we're not doing any hospital procedures today, and I gotta hopefully see if Romeo took what I put the ivermectin in so that I can go back out and give him the rest of his food. He's hanging out at. He must already be. He really enjoys this back bubble area. So Max is still out on vacation, having a great time. You can watch him at bigcatcams.com. Oh, it looks like he left some mush. No, I was just coming to find him, though. My guess is in this back bubble.
My guess too.
Yep. Yep, I see him. He's under this platform. Hi, Kimba. Hi, Sneaky. Where are we going? Where are we going? Hi. I know, you still don't really understand the stabilizer. You still don't fully understand what the stabilizer's about. This is Kimba Tiger. He is our youngest tiger. He's approximately 4 years old. A lot of weird noise today. I've heard ambulance and train and noises I don't usually hear. What are you doing over there? He's eluding us. He's very fierce looking. I can definitely tell he's the one that makes everybody the most nervous. He's been less likely to roar.
Are you growling? Don't growl, mister. Oh my.
But he's the most likely to roar and growl and hiss and put his ears back and charge the side of the cage. which is fine. We don't mind him doing that, but it just makes everybody have to be very, very cautious.
One more drive-by and then we'll go. It's just all your adoring fans. Mr. Handsomes. Mr. Handsomes.
He's still my favorite of the three because he's just so majestic and gorgeous and fierce.
But he doesn't feel the same way about me. I know. Maybe someday. Maybe someday. Okay, I promised. One drive-by and we're out.
I don't like for him to feel like we're pestering him too much. So we will go. Out of the three, Max is probably the one that actually gives me the most attention. He can be very silly and playful. The other two, not so much.
I think he's learning.
That could be it too. Yeah, it's an ivermectin day. Yeah, Kimba doesn't usually leave food, but they start learning quickly when they've been here a couple of months, like what they prefer, and they know we're gonna keep bringing out more and more stuff for them, so they're very smart. But with ivermectin, it's important. It's a monthly medicine that all the cats get, and he probably got a little sense of that in the food this morning.
All right, so we have seen a lot of big cats.
Cougars and leopards, now a tiger and a jaguar. So let's see some of our smaller cats. Of course, they're still feeding in that direction, so we're gonna go this way because I don't, there's some picky cats over there like Diablo and Alethea. And Mouser, and they won't always eat when people are around. So I see Des Serval still in his lockout. He is a clean plate cat for sure.
Did you get every last drop, sir? Did you get every last drop, sir?
So if any of you guys are brand new to us, I'd love for you to put in the comments that you're brand new.
Hi, mister.
So this is Des Serval. An African serval. You can see he's got some mats just like Servy did. He get older and get arthritis, and he only has three legs, so that makes it even harder for him to do grooming. But if you are brand new to us, let us know in the comments and feel free to ask questions because we love to make sure you have accurate information about what you're seeing. There's Nala serval creeping along behind.
Hi, Nala. Are you cozy in there? Are you cozies?
But you can learn about every single cat here and where they came from and how they came to be here and their ages and anniversaries and all that fun stuff if you go to bigcatrescue.org/catbio. Look at his, he's got the cutest ears. Hey, Maria, welcome. Because we do have bio pages for every single cat here. And it gives you a lot of information and a lot of pictures. This duck wire makes it a little hard for him, for us to see him.
I missed her, my goodness. Whoa.
That's the official serval hello, if you can believe that people try to have these as pets.
A lot to say this morning.
So that's his food plate that he's laying on right now. Yeah, Des was actually found on the side of the road near death in Arizona and only had three legs already when he came to us. But he's been here for over 9 years now, living his best life.
Always telling me he sounds like Cookie Monster. I know. I won't follow. I promise.
He's one of my favorite meds cats. He does get pain medication for his arthritis.
You gotta eat grass now?
I know I said I wouldn't follow, but we never get to see him, so.
Mister!
It's like, I'll deal with you later. I do Monday PM meds, so.
Your tail is very expressive today. Very expressive. Okay. I'm gonna go.
I'm going. Well, you can see also, the cats really love me before breakfast. After breakfast, when they already have a full belly, they're kind of like, you can go away now. Des and Kimba have already eaten breakfast. Let's go see. Maybe we'll see some bobcats, and then we'll probably call it a day. Again, you can rewatch this at dailybigcat.com. Max and MaryAnn basically have the size of a football field worth of enclosures. And you just never know where they're gonna be. Plus, they've already had breakfast, so they're probably cuddling and grooming somewhere. Hoping we'll still see them, though.
Oh, MaryAnn! Hi, little girl. Do I have to come all the way around? You gonna stay there if I do?
We'll see. So we gotta walk all the way around the edge here. All the way around the edge. See if we can catch her before she disappears. Thanks to everybody answering questions for me. I've really not been looking at my screen much.
MaryAnn! Thank you, girl! Oh, thanks for staying over here. Thanks for staying over here. Where are you going? Where's Maxie? This is MaryAnn Bobcat. We going for a walk? Going for a walk. Where's Max? Where's Max? Where's that silly boy? Hi, sweet girl. Hi.
Judy, that's a great question. So if a cat was born and raised in a cage by humans, it can never be set free. Most of these cats, with the exception of the bobcats and cougars here, are not native to the U.S., so again, can't release them. But we do rehab and release native Florida wildlife, so bobcats. We've got a bobcat rehab. We have one out in rehab right now who got hit by a car and has 6 fractures in his pelvis. And we're taking care of him and hopefully going to be able to re-release him. His name's Romeo. But unfortunately, MaryAnn had been kept in a backyard menagerie and was rescued with several other cats. We call it the Gilligan's Island Rescue because we do have Gilligan and Lovey, Ginger, and MaryAnn.
Hi, cute girl. It's very fun. Where's the boy?
She was introduced to a male bobcat named Max when they were young. And we don't do any breeding here because, again, we don't believe in,
hey, that's not nice,
in breeding for life in prison. So we don't do any breeding here.
I should have known.
She's one that does not fire blanks.
I should have known. Good thing you didn't get me. Be stuck like this all day.
I don't think I have extra clothes in my office today like I usually do. I used my last set.
Where's Max? Where's Max? Let's go find him. Go see where he is.
He's a very big bobcat.
Maxie!
Oh, they might still be separated for food. That would be why they're not together. Yep, I see a door down. So, we're gonna have to walk all the way back around. see him out though. He's probably in a den back here. Yes, all of our cats are spayed and neutered when they live with another cat, because again, we don't believe in breeding for life in prison. There's no sense in breeding if they're just gonna be stuck in cages and enclosures their whole life. Yeah, MaryAnn has always tried to mark me over the years. I have a very short list, thankfully, of cats that have claimed me.
Maxie, you gotta be in there. Max.
This is Max Bobcat we're looking for, not Tiger. We do have a Max Tiger.
Well, MaryAnn followed us. Did you come all the way around? Girl, where's that boy marking your tree?
Something today is causing her to... Oh, I see him. Oh Lord.
Now I see him. We're gonna get a big bobcat belly. Look at that belly. You are just blending in. Hey, you're still rolling around on this thing. Still rolling around on that. He flattened his tube. This is Max.
Yeah, I've been claimed by Pharaoh, Mrs. Claus, MaryAnn.
What are you doing?
Yeah, we separate cats that live together just at food time, because food and treats, and it's because we don't want them to... What are you doing? We don't want them to ever have to feel like they need to fight or compete for food or...
Oh my, look at that belly. You just loved that tube.
This is from Valentine's Day.
He flattened it, didn't he? It must still have catnip on it. You still have catnip on it?
Max is actually had been kept as a pet in Rhode Island. MaryAnn came to us from Kansas.
Oh my goodness. But he's wild and destructive, and he has some massive nails. Look at that belly. Look at that belly.
All right, everybody. Well, thank you guys for joining us today. And again, welcome to all the newcomers. Thank you to the three people that donated and everyone who shared this feed. That does help us reach new people. We need as many people as possible to help spread the message that these cats don't belong in cages. We do take care of them for the rest of their life, but the ultimate goal is to not have these animals in bad situations that need rescuing. So if you want to rewatch, you'll see Aries Cougar and hear a whole lot of purring from him from the very beginning. It'll post automatically right on our Facebook page as well as dailybigcat.com. And hopefully it'll be a beautiful week, and I will see you guys. My goal is all week long, so what's today, Monday? So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, try to do some morning walkabouts and anything else that might be happening around the sanctuary. And tonight at, I believe, 7:30, I think Deb said they were gonna go live. We're doing a presentation for volunteers and interns that should be really, really interesting. It's somebody we've actually worked with to help support their conservation efforts. So thank you guys so much. I hope you have a great Monday, and again, happy March. And I will see you guys again soon.